Ranger fans, to my review of the Power Rangers Samurai Megazord. This set comes with the 5 main Zords to form the Samurai Megazord from Power Rangers Samurai. You can see we have here the bear, turtle, lion, monkey and dragon over here, which form the Samurai Megazord. And first, let's take a closer look at the box. A very first look. You guys, to the side just a bit. Over here, Red Ranger, European box, so has multiple language, Samurai Megazord. For some reason, some other countries say DX Megazord Samurai and Super Megazord Samurai, because this box, it's from the Super Samurai season, so this is a later edition. I didn't buy the original version, but it's basically the exact same thing, just different things on the front. I have here the other rangers at the sides. All the rest of the stuff, the monkey, ape, turtle in the names. You can form the Megazord over here, Larida. And you can combine multiple Megazords you have to buy the beetle, tiger and swordfish to form the Ultimate Megazord. And then the Gigazord when you have the Clawzord combined also. And the Cycle Crap Megazord, so have formed this little piece of crap. And then the other side you have here the Megazord gimmick for all the years since 2010 with the 2010 Megazord, this guy, and the new the Gosei Great Megazord, which has the Zord Builder System gimmick, so yeah, you can combine with any of them. I see you can form this beautiful picture piece of crap, which is the Gigazord with fucking skates. So, off to the side. Have you all the main Zords. Let's take a closer look, please. First of all, the smallest one, the turtle. See, nicely simple. The sky symbol at the back, pink color, the only pink on here on the entire Megazord, and also these two eyes. Articulation, just the flaps on his feet and nothing more to it. Very simple, but still very accurate. Nothing too much. Has some nice details, like on the shell you have these little dots, circle dots, which is the circle from the symbol of his shape of the turtle, so not bad. Now the monkey, also not too bad. It has the Shiba logo, the Shiba Samurai logo from Shinkengers. Both sides actually, nicely front. They're missing some painted. At least all of them missing some paint. This one you can notice like a little. I think it's a white stripe at the center, but that's about it. In other places also, this is a more noticeable one. I have here the details to form the land symbol, which unfortunately you can't, but I'll talk about later. And also the little dots with the triangle shape, which is the shape of the monkey when in the emblem mode. Sorry, I don't remember. Next, you have dragon, which is the ugliest of them all, because if you notice the dragon from the show and Shinkengers, it basically like like this form, like a snake. Does this look like a snake to you? Or even a dragon? This looks like a puppy or something. Like I said, and out can open, so not too bad. And you can store both the sword on his ass. For some reason, it's not bad for the kids to lose them, but still looks ugly as hell. And you can store the helmet underneath. And also, the detail from the water symbol is over here, but unfortunately they didn't paint it, which is kind of a letdown. But some blue paint has to be some dark paint or some light paint to make it stand out, because it looks a bit ugly. Have any details? Please paint the details, Bandai, please. We're not asking that much, and possibly. Just the ass, and the neck can go up and down, but because of transformation and amount. Oh, I forgot to show. The monkey can just move his arms, rotating, and can go back and forth. And that's about it for the monkey. Now the bear. Bear, it's a very simple one. Looks like a bear. See? Mouth can open. Nice, nighty. Some nice detail of teeth. Teeth. How the heck you say teeth? Teeth? Tooth? That's okay. Head can go up and down. Arms can go this way and this way, just to the sides, and also the feet to the side, and Shiba logo over here. Also, the dragon has it on his neck over there, as you can see. And also, where they, this one is on these flippers over here. You see? Shiba logo. Bad. Unfortunately, you can't do this like in the original Shinkenger, where you can move the head this way and you can do like blubber, but okay. And now the last one, the red line for the. I think this is the second red line. The first one, I think, was from from Wild Force, if I'm not mistaken. At least I think. It was not bad. It has details over here of his just a half fire symbol. The rest is over here at the sides. Missing paint again. Shiba logo. The what the heck this shape is? Hexagonal shape or something on the on these details. That's about it. Nice on the front. Head. Mouth can open. And it has some little details of a little tongue or something on the inside. Feet can go to the side, we have to snap the arms, it's make, see, let's click in joint, and the feet can go just this, nothing more. They're all very simple, basic, they're very, very simple Megazords, who don't have a lot of articulation, so it's very simple. Now, to form two Megazords, first, get these two, to form the Megazord, like we're saying, get these guys. Fold the arms from the bear and the legs also, and then flip the head backwards. You have one leg, and also when the legs, for because of the transformation of the legs, instead of being like this straight, they are on a little of an angle, as you can see. And they're not flat because of the Megazords how it stands. Now. Remove the sword from Dragon S. To take the helmet, press this little button over here. And then remove it. And then close this part and flip the head forward. There you have the other leg. And unfortunately, because of this, they don't stand that well. Unfortunately, without the main torso. So, to do the line, pull the feet forward. Then flip the arms or the feet or the whatever you're gonna call this backwards. Then you snap them like so. Then flip it forward like so. Then you have the connector packs back on the holes and then connect it. There you go. Now zoom up and home. Turtle, open them up like so. To snap it, close the flippers and rotate that on the inside, and then rotate the fist and then connect it to the Megazord. Monkey, very simple, easy transformation. Just do this: flip the arms to the straight like so, and then close it. To form the fists and peg it. Connector pegs are tough sometimes. Finally, to form the head, flip the head upwards, get the helmet and open them up, and then connect it. And also the sword, you can put on the end or something like that, and there you go. Samurai Megazord. As you can see, Samurai Megazord looks okay. Looks like in the show, it's not bad. Not perfect, but looks like it. It looks very much like nice show. You can see nicely. Posability, just Megazord-ish, typical movement. Arms can rotate. Because of transformation and because of the way of doing it, you can move the fists to the side on the turtle, and the feet, you can rotate them just a bit to the sides because of the connector packs, and that's about it for movements. One thing I can say, the Megazord head looks not bad, very nice. When you have the helmet on, you can cover the eyes just a bit, but you can still see not too bad. You have the swords, which does have some nice detail. I don't know if I can show it. We have the turtle over here, the monkey, the bear, the dragon over here, and then the lion. Which this sword is it's actually a very nice detail from both the show and the original Shinkenger's Megazord, because Shinkenger, the original Megazord, only have one side of the blade, so having both sides, it's a nice idea, not a bad game, it's a sword. Shinkenger didn't have, because one side was basically to store the weapon, to do like so. You can do it in the Megazord, it basically just stays there by the way the weapon stores, because of the hilt over there, it sticks on the upper, the below the arms, so it doesn't look that bad. It's okay to store the weapon if you don't want to have it like this, just holding it. You can hold it on both hands. This one, you can see this the hilt, the guard, or the hilt, or that thing called. But on the monkey hand, yeah, you can have it on the other side. So it's basically your choice of storing it or showing it. I prefer to have mine like this. So that's basically it. My final thoughts on this guy? Well, it's one of the biggest pieces of crap Bandai has made for the past couple of years. Why? So basically, this maker is 100% completely different from the Shinkenger's toy line, and it has three main problems, for me at least. One, doesn't have the emblem mode. Technically, the only emblem mode you have is this thing. Turtle is the only one who has the emblem mode, so basically just luck of how the transformation for the turtle is, you can use it, because I'll talk about on the next video a little bit more detail. This is basically just a review. The next one will be an entire rant about it. A second thing, the price killed me for it. I know in the States it was about $40 or some, 39 or ish, 37, I don't know. I think it was about 29, 39, something, east on the first release, I don't remember. But in Europe, all countries in Europe were 60 euros. I know, for the American viewers, picture buying a Megazord this crappy for $60. Imagine that. Just tell me, would you buy this guy for $60? Hell no. This thing, Eastern America, was a nice price, $30. It's a relatively okay price. Unfortunately, for the last 2 years, this first year when it was released in America, and the second year was released in Europe, I had to wait almost 1 year for me to buy this thing, because the prices, at least on Toys R Us, never dropped. I think it started from 60, then later on dropped to 50, then to 50 to 45. If you check almost every website on Toys R Us, this Megazord costs about 40 to 50 euros, at least now. in certain countries, Megazord or Megaforce are starting to show up, so it's technically not still available, at least in certain some countries, depending on which one. So this thing was very expensive to buy. I didn't buy it because it was too expensive. At night, I bought it because it was 45 and Toys R Us was having a 30% off. So I bought this guy for about 30 bucks. 30.99 cents, which was the price I was waiting for. I had to wait almost 1 year to buy this thing. And also, the third thing, it's the... these guys over here. I know the Tiger was okay, like in Shinkengers, but Beetlezord and Swordfish, at least I know Beetlezord, I know Beetleborgs, were completely different from the original Shinkengers toy line. I'll talk about on the metal later on. Now, recommendations. Would I recommend you buying this? For those who have, they already know. For those who don't have it yet, buy only for your kids, because Bandai is using, only selling these things for kids, because they don't give a crap about the collector. The collector is, and for the collector value, in America, they are selling the original Shikeno as a deluxe Shikeno import from Japan, which costs about 80 bucks ish. I probably won't buy the original Shikeno in Europe, because they won't sell it. Will probably never sell it. At least I think they won't, but that's about me. This, I would only recommend this thing for kids or people who would never buy or can't afford to buy the original Shikeno. It's a nice substitute. It has just enough details to make it at least fun. Just have it on the shelf. Just that. I don't mind. It's okay. Not perfect. If he had the emblem mode, it would be perfect, but it doesn't have. At least it is proportion-wise okay, because you can see the legs, like in the show, like the suits. But to see the, like in Shikeno, he only had this like little part of leg, just this big. So, proportion-wise, it's okay. It's a nice figure. I don't mind it. Just the cost that killed me. So, next video, I'm gonna do a little rant about what Bandai did to the Samurai line that was so terrible. At least in Europe-wise. So, that's all for now, guys. See you guys next time. Same time, same channel.